As drones become more widely used in everyday life, one state agency is taking these unmanned aerial vehicles to new heights.
MnDOT is studying how drones can hopefully make all of us safer by looking for defects in bridges. Soon, they'll begin the second phase of a study that will compare the visual images captured by drones to what a human bridge inspector would see. And that could someday reduce both, lower the cost and lower the risk. Bill Hudson is at the Lowry Bridge.
Yeah, he's here to explain how it works. Hi, Bill. This sounds interesting.
Sure does.
Well, you guys are absolutely right. There are some 25,000 of these bridges across the state that require inspection. But let's be clear about one thing. This isn't about replacing human bridge inspectors with these unmanned aerial vehicles or so-called drones. Think of this as just another high-tech tool that can even at times go places human eyes can't.
Ever since the catastrophic collapse of the 35W bridge in Minneapolis, Minnesota's Department of Transportation has been working to improve its bridge inspection program. It's about to take a high-tech turn.
There are areas where we can't access regularly or it's too dangerous to access.
This summer, Jennifer Zink and other MnDOT engineers began studying the use of drones to help visualize, record, and capture bridge infrastructure, to essentially compare results with what human eyes currently do.
You'll be able to see exactly what the drone's seeing real time, so we can know if there's something that we have to investigate further by getting up close.
You know, why send a human life out there when you can equally accomplish the same thing with a small UAV?
Charles Ide is a local drone expert and trains UAV operators around the country. He's not surprised MnDOT is putting drones to work.
The big question we have to ask ourselves is, if there's a tool that doesn't endanger human lives that can do as good or better job, why wouldn't you use that tool? And I think in this instance, MnDOT really gets that.
Early results of the study look promising, so MnDOT will expand the study this fall, and it hopes to win federal approval to expand the use of a high-flying tool that could someday make a risky job both safer and less costly.
And that's the whole point here, is to try to reduce cost of the program, maybe make the whole bridge inspection program even that much more efficient with 25,000 bridges. Now this fall, they're going to go up into the Blatnick Bridge in Duluth and actually examine the underside of that massive bridge. And what's interesting, you guys, is that once the St. Croix River Crossing Bridge is completed, that's going to take an awful lot of inspection on an ongoing basis. They're even talking about using drones for that. We'll have to see next summer.
Yeah, Bill. Well, it seems to make sense.
Pardon?
It seems to make sense to do this.
It makes absolute sense. You're absolutely right, Amelia. So we'll see what the FAA says about that. Mm-hmm. Of course, that is still in limbo right now.
All right. Thank you, Bill.
You bet.